Did we check in here? Yeah, but there's just people whose souls we can read. I got as much right to stand here as the guys going into the that whorehouse. They don't like what I gotta say. They can go someplace else. Show them the dagger you found on Darren. This belonged to you? That's mine, all right, and no one touches my dagger and lives. Save yourself the trouble. For a little coin, you can keep your dagger and your pride. Fine, here, let's keep this between us. Yay, training ground structure completed.
Really?
Oh, yay. Okay. So what was I going to work on next? Oh, yeah, craft hall.
Wow.
I've got a... We've got a good amount of money here. Craft hall, let's go ahead. Maybe? Hold on. Just in case. Increases our lore, which would be nice. That way we only really have to, I guess, up the rest, yeah, up our lore up to 3, I suppose. Okay, that's already all done. The towers will grant a perception bonus when resting at Bright Hollow. Perception's also pretty good, and it also gives... Botanical garden, hedge maze, warden's lodge. We could do the warden's lodge. There's also the wooden trails. Upgrading the lodge will grant a bonus to the survival skill upon resting at Bright Hall, as well as provide access to the warden, who offers high level bounties. Oh, interesting. And then there's... Okay, so this adds a con and athletics bonus. And the last three just add prestige, right? Yeah, it just adds prestige. Which, not particularly worried about prestige. I suppose, yeah. Botanical garden. Training grounds is done. Bonus resolve, which I kind of like. Kind of like a resolve bonus. You know what? I'm going to do the tower. What are the towers? Oh. Now let's go ahead and head into here. Wait, hold on. It's a passageway. Over here. Quick save, and boom. All right, let's get these trolls taken care of, and then get out of the way.
The keep's coming.
Here we go. Oh, there's the maze. Like it. I like it. That must be the... I'm gonna guess this is the chapel. Here, whenever it gets made up. Oh, this is the training ground? Yes. I want to look at this item. Where are you at? Are you a potion? Uses 3. Oh, it only has up to 3 actual uses. Oh, not bad, really. Okay, what else? Ah, here we are. And there's you. Grants Mind Lance plus 1 per rest. With a plus 3 constitution. Suppose I could do that. And I'm still a hell of a lot more tankier than Edder. Still a lot more tankier than Edder. Damn. Just damn. Suppose, all right, let's see what we can enchant you. Oh, we still can't even do fine. What are we missing? Pilgrim's Crown. Enter his meadows in the plains of Ixmetil, and less commonly in the deerwood. They're frequently woven into the garlands. Woven into garlands and wreaths. Many a pair of infatuated youths has passed a pilgrim's crown between them. Hey, Grouchy Crusader, how's it going? Evening Z, finally made it to toward the beginning of the stream. There you go. Yep. I'd say close enough. Welcome back, buddy. All right. Maybe something that I have plenty of, maybe like the corrode. I definitely have plenty corrode. You know what? Yeah, I have plenty corrode. But kind of prefer to give it this stuff. This I know I won't be able to do at all. All right. Well, there's nothing really else I can do here. Damn, now my con is pretty freaking good. Constitution, endurance, and health plus 14 fortitude. How are you doing today, Grouchy Crusader? Oh, right.
Better indeed.
Thank you. Go ahead and manually resolve this. I'll buy one of these. All right, you did your thing. Plus four. Ah, yeah, let's do this. Boom and boom. Doing better today. Illness is acting as isn't acting as bad. Have I been? I've been doing pretty good. Your illness? I didn't hear about that. What happened? What'd you catch? Doesn't sound all. Oh. Hopefully it's not all too bad. In a lifelong thing, mental illness. Oh, okay. I suppose it's a hazard AoE. Oh god, I gotta read these things again. Friendly target, okay. Shining beacon. Got it. Well, glad it's not acting up as bad today, Grouchy. Sweet. Tower's construction started. Right, that finishes in 2 days, 1 hour. Okay. Hey, keep defenses successful. Yes.
Very.
It seems your fame is spreading. I have heard travelers speaking of your accomplishments in Defiance Bay.
Positive three. What is the state of the keep? Okay. Okay. I think I'm gonna bring her along.
See you when I see you.
Okay, her lore is fine. I don't think I need to bring that up anymore. Out of curiosity, it would only go up to three, but we should put this up to three. Next up, inspiring triumph. Passive allied AoE plus 7 defenses for and inspires all allies in the vicinity when the paladin downs an enemy. Done.
I'm ready.
Okay, and you're wielding a fine greatsword, but I got a better greatsword for you. A much better greatsword. Yep. And now let's go ahead and work on. Oh, crap. I don't. Oh, you need equipment. Oh, you can't. I'm guessing because you're like a you're a godlike, you can't wear helmets. Well, that's unfortunate. Hold on. I'm gonna get rid of you.
You walk your path, I'll walk mine.
Okay, for the time being, so that way I can grab from you. Oh, just put this on here. Plus two dex. Oh yeah, you can't wear that. What does this do for you? Yeah, godlike can't wear wear helmets. Horns make it a little awkward. Yeah, much like Quinari in Dragon Age. Much like Quinari. Okay, plus 50% armor reduction when under 25% health. Seems pretty good. I might actually just keep her with that. Yeah, I think I'll just keep her with that. Against prone attacks. You got a fine pistol. Okay.
See you when I see you.
What?
Hey, Edder, don't take this the wrong way, but we need to take your clothes. That's pretty much how it is. That's pretty much the gist of the whole thing. Okay, let's see how this goes. I took away probably a really tanky character. I'm sort of an off
better
tank.
Better indeed.
Right.
Yeah, I'm sort of an off tank. Quick question, guys. Quick question, chat. Oh yeah. Okay, I think I just answered my own question. Yes, never mind. Never mind. I just figured out the answer to my own question. All right, we're gonna start working on her quest. Oh, I forgot a rest. Oh well.
Hmm?
Yeah, you used up all your fourth level. You used up a. You're still good. Like these. Oh, these are like nuts. Yeah, we're still fine. We're still fine.
Ambassador Agosti, I would speak with you on a matter of some urgency and great importance.
Sighing, as though remembering some heavy burden, Vincent crosses his arms before replying. Pellegrina, if this is the same matter we previously discussed, I doubt I will be convinced any more easily. Quit stonewalling and pay attention for once. Aggressive, passionate. Defiance Bay, positive 3. Ha-ha! And the ambassador regards you with a measure of apprehension. You have my attention, Zircon. Zircon, is it? But unless Pellegrina has compelling reason to interfere in Defiance Bay's political matters, it is the position of the Dukes that we should avoid unnecessary entanglements.
Ambassador, there are issues at stake here that go beyond rogue merchants and the port staying open. Animancy is under attack in Defiance Bay.
We have to protect our interests here, but that also means knowing when to avoid unnecessary entanglements. The Animancers and the locals have problems. They'll work them out, or they won't. Either way, there's too much to risk by getting involved.
If it is outlawed here, what would prevent the same from happening in our republics?
The ambassador's face vacillates between expressions of sympathy and frustration. Pellegrina, I do not think your concerns are unfounded, but it is not the place of this embassy to countermand the Republic's policies. What kind of spineless do-nothing are you if you and the Dukes aren't going to take her seriously? Shove off. Pellegrina's golden eyes grow wide, but she remains speechless. Despite her shock, a stifled smile breaks through for a moment. The ambassador blinks, clearly unprepared for your outburst. Well, we all have our roles to play. For better or worse, I am the Duke's representative, not Pellegrina's advocate.
What is it the Dukes need of me, Ambassador?
The Deerwood's instability has created an opportunity for us to take over their trade with the Irrigland Foth. We will need to meet the Glandfathen soon to secure upcoming trade agreements. The roads to Twin Elms can be dangerous, of course, but that's why you'll be representing there.
Echosi, Ambassador, but won't this provoke the Deerwoodens? Their country is falling apart, and we're already dividing up their trade alliances.
Provoke them into what? Going to war? Through no fault of the Republic's, the Deerwood's armies have been deprived of an entire generation of soldiers. It would be foolish not to take advantage of the situation. If we don't, the Riad-Sirens will. Ambassador, that's some cold compassion considering what these people have been through.
More than that, Ambassador, there is a practical element to consider. We may profit in the short term from this arrangement, but what of the future? The Deerwood won't forget, and the Republics may pay the price for it.
The Ambassador sighs. We're not the Ducks, Pellegrina. It's their decision and our job to carry out the orders. It's not like they're asking you to assassinate someone. Pellegrina raises an eyebrow and clenches her jaw but remains silent. Pellegrina, shakes his head. Go to Twin Elms. Speak to the Anamantfoth, impress upon her the instability of the Deerwood, and treasure her of the alien Republic's desire to open safe trade.
Of course, Ambassador.
The Ambassador nods and smiles paternally. He then looks to you. I know you planned on investigating this crisis together, but I hope you understand Pellegrina's responsibility. You love Pellegrina, feisty paladin? I'm kind of seeing that. I understand, but we're still going to investigate responsibilities or not. Vincent bristles and turns to Pellegrina. Will the ducks need to hear more about Pellegrina's Pellegrina Mesrae's wild adventures?
Of course not, Ambassador. I will attend to the Anamantfoth as soon as I am able to travel to Twin Elms.
Good. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Could have gone better. Could have gone worse. I appreciate that you stood up for me, but it's hard to persuade the ambassador to go against the Duke's orders.
I know you're right, Pelagina. We may find a way for you to fulfill your obligations while looking into what's really going on around here. Don't worry.
Enough wisdom for both of us. Now, I just need to find out how to get to Twin Elms before the ambassador loses his patience.
She pauses in thought. Still, I fear that making this deal with the Glantfathans will further weaken the Deerwood and make trouble for the Republicans in the years to come. Follow your heart. Do what you believe will be best for the Republicans.
I wish I knew.
Okay. I'm not gonna lie, she's going to be leveling up a lot faster than all of us combined. It's going to be kind of nuts due to the fact that I gave her... Man. All right. So I'm probably gonna work with her for a little bit and see how things go and see if I like her. Yep, we got two paladins in the... we got two paladins. Which is good. Double the crusade. For a while. I need to get my guy to be able to engage more people, though. Because that is my main aspect of this character. He is a tank. And a very powerful one at that. He just needs to be able to engage more guys at once. So what we're going to go ahead and do is we're going to start going down the catacombs. Because we're out of tasks. We are out of tasks due. At least for the city so far. But okay, so since now I have essentially two DPS characters, I'm gonna do this. Two DPS characters and one tank. I will eventually probably go back to two tanks. Okay, I already checked out that much of this in here. This is that thing.
No good. No good. No good.
God, what are you doing? Oh, geez. You might as well summon your minions. Closer and boom. Oh, I was gonna say, I was like, oh, is that what I need for the fine crafting? Nope, that's just dark spores.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea.